Welcome to the YouTube channel, which is Learning Institute. And today I am going to discuss about the things of differential equation and its applications. So let's start the video. Content: introduction of differential equations, invention of differential equations, order and degree of differential equations, formation of differential equations, ordinary differential equations, solution of differential equations, and method for solving ordinary differential equation, also the real time application of differential equation. What are the differential equations? Calculus, the science of the rate of change, was invented by the Newton in investigation of natural phenomena. So first time in the science, the rate of change was invented by Newton in his natural phenomena. Many other types of system can be modeled by writing down an equation for the rate of change of phenomena. Bandwidth utilization in TCP networks, acceleration of car, also velocity, population increase, also we can find the chemical change of some kind using differential equations, locus of a football. All the above behavior can be captured by very simple differential equations. A mathematical equation that relates a function with its derivatives is called a differential equation. The function usually represents physical quantities. Derivatives represent its rate of change. So differential equation defines a relationship between the two. That is physical quantity and its derivative, rate of change. History of differential equations. Origin of differential equations. Who invented idea and background idea. In mathematical history of differential equation traces the development of differential equations from calculus itself, independently invented by English physicist Isaac Newton and German mathematician Gottfried Leibniz. The history of the subject of differential equations in concise form is the process of the recent article The History of Differential Equation, 1670 to 1950. We can find an average slope between two points, but how we do find slope at a single point? Clear? We can find an average slope between two points by using the coordination formula. But the question is, how do we find the slope at a point? But with derivative, we use a small derivative with small difference, then have it sink towards zero. As is, slope equals change in y and upon change in x. So we can find the slope of this line by this formula: slope equals change in y upon change in x. Similarly, we can find average slope of this curve between these two points as but the question is how this is this find. So we can find this as we take a small displacement along y direction as delta y and a small displacement along x direction as delta x and then taking limit tending to 0. As slope equal change in x upon change in y upon change in x delta y upon delta x. Differential calculus real time video. The original differential equation is an equation with a function and one or more of its derivatives. Differential equation can be represented as y plus dy by dx equals 5x. Here y is a function and its derivative is dy by dx. Here are the sum equations: y double prime plus y prime minus 2y equals 3. So this is a differential form. So we can say this is a differential equation because it has a derivative component in it, this term. Also, this equation is a differential equation because it has a differential component in it, that is dy by dx. This equation is not a differential because it does not have differential nor derivative component in it. Also, this is not a differential equation because it is not a form of equation, have no equal sign, even though it has a derivative component in it. So since it has no equal sign, so it is not a differential equation. So these are the differential equation, formation of differential equations. The family of straight lines represented by y equal mx. And on differentiating with respect to x, we can find as. So this is a differential equation of first order. This is a differential equation of the first order. Also, we can assume the family of curves are represented by y equal a cos x plus b, where a and b are arbitrary constant. On differentiating with respect to x, we get dy by dx equal minus a sin x plus b. Again differentiating, we can get d2y upon dx2 equal minus a cos x plus b. Formation of differential equation. So this is a differential equation of second order because it is the second order derivative of y with respect to x. Similarly, by eliminating three arbitrary constants, a differential equation of third order is obtained. Here is two order and two arbitrary constant. Similarly, we can eliminate three arbitrary constant and we get a third order differential equation. Generally, eliminating n arbitrary constants, a differential equation of n order is obtained. So as many as the arbitrary constant, the order of the differential equation is the same. Order and degree. For example, this is the differential equation d2y upon dx2 plus dy by dx plus y equal 4x cube minus 24. In this term, order is the highest derivative. So we see that in this differential equation, the order is 2. It is the first derivative, is the first derivative or a second derivative, etc. तो order को हम define करते हैं, order एक highest derivative. So this is d2y by dx2 in this differential equation, this is the highest derivative. For example, dy by dx plus y square equal 5x, it has only first derivative dy by dx, so it is first order. Similarly, we can take another example, d2y upon dx2 plus xy equals sin x. This has a second derivative, so its order is 2. And similarly, this equation has the order 3. Degree. The degree is the exponent of the highest derivative. The highest derivative is just dy by dx in this equation, and it has an exponent of 2, so this is the second degree. This is the first order and second degree. So we can call it first order, second degree ordinary differential equation. Similarly, for this equation, the highest order derivative is dqy upon dx3 plus dy by dx2, but the highest derivative is dqy upon dx3. It has no exponent, so we can call it as first degree. So this equation is the third order first degree ordinary differential equation. Third order first degree ordinary differential equation. We can solve it when we discover the function y or a set of function y. There are many tricks to solving differential equations, but first y. Solution of a differential equation. The solution of a differential equation is the relation between the variables satisfying the given differential equation and containing as many arbitrary constant as its order is. The differential equation of a solution, a solution of a differential equation is a relation between variable which satisfy the given differential equation and containing the same number of arbitrary constant, and it is the order. Which is I discussed earlier, as many as the arbitrary constant, and so it is the order. If the arbitrary constants are 2, then its differential equation has the order 2. For example, y equal a cos x minus b sin x. So we get the differential equation of this form, d2y by dx2 plus 4y equals 0. General solution. If the solution of a differential equation of nth order contains n arbitrary constants, the solution is called the general solution. Clear? A cos x minus b sin x is the general solution of the differential equation. This. Y equal to minus b sin x is not the general solution because it contains only one arbitrary constant. So this is not the solution of this differential equation because it has the 2 degree. So it must contain the 2 arbitrary constant. Particular solution. A solution obtained by giving particular values to the arbitrary constant in general solution. This solution is called a particular solution. So arbitrary constant is given by the particular value, and this value is called the particular solution. For example, y equals 3 cos x minus 2 sin x. We get this differential equation, and we can say that it is a particular solution of the differential equation. variable separable. The first order differential equation can take as dy by dx equal to f of xy. It's called the separate provided by fxy can be written as the product of a function of x, product of a function of x and a function of y as dy by dx equal g of x h of y. Then we can say that the separate variables are gx and hy, and then we can divide hy in left side and dx multiply in right side. On integrating we get the solution as, and c is the integration constant or arbitrary constant. Separation of variables is a special method to solve differential equation. As we discussed earlier, we can transfer y from right side to left, dy by y equal 5x dx, then we can integrate to solve the differential equation. Look like as y is transferred to left side and dx is here. Homogeneous differential equation. A first order differential equation is homogeneous when it can be taken in this form, dy by dx equal f of y upon x. We can solve it by using separation of variable, but first we create a new variable v equal yx, then we get y equal vx. After differentiating with respect to x using product rule, we get this, and finally dy by dx equal v plus x dv upon dx. So we simply put y equal vx and dy by dx equal this much in this equation, differential equation, and then integrating we get the solution. Application of differential equation. Newton's law of cooling states that the rate of change of temperature of an object is proportional to the difference between its own temperature and the temperature of its surrounding. So the cooling is depend on the change in his temperature and the surrounding temperature, and this is equal to the rate of change of temperature of an object. So first time the rate was used by Newton's law of cooling. Applications on Newton's law of cooling. Investigations can be used to determine the time of death. Computer manufacturing, processor, cooling systems, solar water heater, calculating the surface areas of an object. Why are differential equations useful? In our world, things change, and describing how they change often ends up as a differential equation. So how we can define the change with respect to time? So here differential equation is very useful. Example, take example of rabbits. Here we are showing the population growth. The more rabbits we have, the more babies rabbits we get. Then those rabbits grows up and they have babies too. The population will grow faster and faster. The important part of this are the population we take as n at any time t, and the growth rate is r. The population rate of change d by dt of n. Let us imagine some actual values. So suppose the population n is 1000 and the growth rate is 0.01. न्यू रैबिट्स पर वीक. फॉर एवरी करेंट रैबिट पॉपुलेशन वी कैन फाइंड द पॉपुलेशन एज 1000. दिस 1000 मल्टीप्लाई बाय दिस रेट 0.01 वी गेट द 10 न्यू रैबिट्स पर वीक. तो दिस इज द ग्रोथ पर वीक एंड वी फाइंड दिस बाय रेट विच इज एज अ डिफरेंशियल इक्वेशन एप्लीकेशन. But that is only true at a specific time and does not include that the population is constant increasing. Remember, the bigger the population, the more new rabbits we get. As many bigger the population, the more new rabbits we get. So it is better to say that the rate of change is the growth rate times the population. And we can write this as dn by dt. This is the rate of change. N is the population. At any time t, we can represent as n of t. The population at particular time t and the rate of change is dn by dt and is equal to the growth rate of time the population at that. R is the growth rate times means multiplication the population at that instant. So here dn by dt is the rate of change, growth rate is the r is simply the growth rate, and n is the population at that instant. And finally, this is a differential equation, dn by dt equal r of n. So this is a very important application of differential equation in real life. And how powerful mathematics is, that sort equation says, ek sort equation batata hai, the rate of change of population over time, rate of change of population over time equal the growth rate times the population. So this is the dn by dt is the rate of change equal growth rate multiply by population at that instant. Also in simple harmonic motion in physics, simple harmonic motion is a type of periodic motion where the restoring force is directly proportional to the displacement. So we can take an example. Given by a mass on a spring gets a weight attached to it. So we get the weight is, so when we attach a weight on a spring, the weight is pulled down the gravity. The tension in the spring increases as it stretch. जैसे जैसे वेट हम इंक्रीज करेंगे वैसे वैसे टेंशन इंक्रीज होगा स्प्रिंग के ऊपर. देन द स्प्रिंग बाउंसेस बैक अप एंड देन बैक डाउन, अप एंड डाउन अगेन एंड अगेन. दिस इज द ओरिजिनल स्प्रिंग एंड आफ्टर वी अटैच 8 वेट we get the displacement due to the gravity. And similarly here, so this force contain acceleration term and acceleration has the differential term. So it is also a very important application of the differential equation. आज की वीडियो में इतना ही. So थैंक यू।